Okay. A boat is pulled in by means of a winch on a dock 12 feet above the deck of the boat. The winch pulls the rope at the rate of 4 feet per second. Determine the speed of the boat when there is 13 feet of rope out. So here's the basic understanding of the picture here. A winch is nothing more than a type of pulley. So we're cranking this boat in. So here's the winch that's on the dock. Now, how far and above the dock or the boat is this winch or this pulley being located? Well, they tell us a boat is being pulled in by means of a winch on a dock 12 feet above the deck, which means if I know that this is the deck, I know that this is going to be 12 right here. So this distance, this height is 12 from the deck of the boat to the winch. Then it says the winch pulls the rope in. Well, where's the rope? Well, the rope is the hypotenuse of our triangle that looks like. So here's the rope. So the rope is getting pulled in at a rate. Well, the word rate means derivative of 4 feet per second. Well, what rate? What derivative? The rope. So if we say this is R, which is our rope, we know that there's R, which is our rope. We know that this rate, this derivative is getting pulled in. Now, that means the derivative of the rope is 4 feet per second. The question is it positive or negative? Now, if the rope is way far out and the boat is going away from the dock, the rope is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. But if the winch is pulling it in, and the boat is getting closer and closer, that means the rope is getting smaller and smaller, which means the distance is getting smaller, which means we have a negative rate. It's getting pulled in at the rate of 4 feet per second. Notice the direction that the boat would be traveling. Now, here's the big mistake. We tend to think that the rope is the guy on the bottom, but the rope is the hypotenuse on top. Now, what's happening to the boat? The boat is getting pulled in, but the boat isn't going to fly out of the water and jump up on top of the dock. The boat just gets closer and closer to the dock. So that means the boat is getting pulled in horizontally along the water. It's not going to fly out of the water. It's just going to get pulled in closer to the dock. So this part of the boat is getting pulled in. So here's the boat. It's moving horizontally. So it looks like the base of the triangle. All right. So we have the winch. We know that the winch is 12 feet above the deck of the boat. It says the winch pulls the rope in at a rate derivative of 4 feet per second, but we recognized it was negative because it's getting smaller. Then it says determine the speed of the boat. Now, speed, once again, speed means derivative, the speed of the boat. Well, we can say B for boat. So what we're looking for is dB dt is the question. If we say the boat is the B. When there is 13 feet of rope, where's the rope? The rope is attached to the winch to the boat, which means we're talking about when R is 13 feet. When R is 13 feet. So we have our picture, we have our sidebar. The question is, how are we going to relate all of these things into one equation? Well, I hope we recognize that we have a triangle. What we see is we have this triangle. We have a height, we have a hypotenuse R, and we have a B. Well, what do we know? We know that if we're looking at side lengths, we can relate everything in this triangle to Pythagorean theorem. We can say that b squared plus h squared equals r squared. Awesome. Just like the one when we had the plane flying over the radar tracking station. Well, let's count. One, two, three. Three variables. How many rates? One. That's a problem. Can't do it. But what did we learn last time? There was somebody in the problem that was constant. Well, what we determined was that the height from the winch to the deck of the boat is 12. We're not going to assume that the dock all of a sudden is going to crash into the water and it's going to change height. or the boat for some reason is going to fly up out of the water. So the height of the distance between the deck of the boat and the winch is going to stay 12, which means it's a constant value. So in other words, H is a number. So really, I only have two variables here. H isn't important in terms of taking the derivative. But what we saw last time, even though the H isn't important for the derivative, he's going to be vital for us to figure out the last part of our problem. So now that we've created an equation that relates everything over here into one expression, let's go ahead and take a derivative. The derivative of b squared would be 2b, and then we would say db dt, the derivative of the boat with respect to time. Now, h, again, h is just a number. That means the derivative of a number is zero, so we can say plus zero or does not write it at all. R squared, the derivative of r squared would be 2r, and again, dr dt, the derivative of the rope with respect to time. So, now that we have all that, let's plug in everything we know into our problem and let's simplify. Well, we have 2 times b. Well, we don't have a b, so we're going to leave it. db dt, well, it's what we're looking for, so we're going to leave it. db dt equals 2 times r. Well, they did tell us r was 13. Well, that's great. And they told us dr dt was a negative 4. That's also great. So now what I'm looking for is db dt. Let's solve this problem for db dt. db dt is going to equal 2 times 13 times negative 4 all over 2 times b. Well, the 2's can cross out, but I'm still missing a piece of the puzzle. I still don't know what b is. Now, that means we have to remember something. Even though the height was constant and wasn't needed over here, he's going to be important to finding what this is. Let's go back to our problem. If we remember that the height was 12, that's going to be important for us to finding the missing b. They also told us that they want it at the instant the rope is 13. Could they change that number from 13 to 10 to 2? Sure, but they want it at the instant the rope is 13 feet out. This number 12 is never going to change. This number 13, depending on what they want and where the boat is in process coming into the dock, could change. But at this moment, they want it to be 13 feet. That means we can solve for b using the basic Pythagorean theorem, which means b equals the square root of 13 squared minus 12 squared, 169 minus 144, b is 5. If you don't know that number, to substitute the whole entire expression right on in, which means what we have is 13 times negative 4 over 5. Now we're looking at the boat. The boat is a distance traveling. So again, this would be in terms of feet per second. So once again, just like the radar tracking station question, and now the winch question, what we're seeing is when we have the Pythagorean theorem, somebody's constant, fantastic, which means we don't really need it for the derivative, but we absolutely will need it in terms of getting our unknown side length. So now let's look at the last type of question, which is a very classic question that appears a ton. It's the famous ladder sliding down a wall. What happens when the ladder slides down? What happens to the area of the change? What happens to the angle relationships? There's always three questions that we could always ask when the ladder slides down the wall. So let's investigate a typical ladder question.